بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. My dear respected beloved brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum. May the peace and blessings of Almighty Allah be with each and every one of you. I take this opportunity to welcome you to our daily live stream broadcast. This program is coming to you from your Zawiya here at the Islamic Forum of Canada. We thank you for joining us today, and we hope you can be with us every day at 7 p.m. Toronto time. We kindly request you to contact your family members, your relatives, your friends, and other Muslims you know. Tell them about this program and remind them to sign in to the chat now. Inshallah, they will benefit from the program and you will receive great blessings from Almighty Allah. The first segment of our program consists of special Quran recitation, followed by sacred words of dhikr, then a special dua for each and every one of you. The second segment of our program consists of special lectures for your educational upliftment. The third segment of our program focuses on qasida training for you. The fourth and final segment is the interactive segment, including Q&A, question and answer session, project updates, my concluding remarks, and a special dua for everyone. Once again, thank you for being a part of the IFC family. We hope you enjoy and you benefit from this program, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألف لام ميم ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين الذين يؤمنون بالغيب ويقيمون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون والذين يؤمنون بما أنزل إليك وما أنزل من قبلك وبالآخرة هم يوقنون أولئك على هدى من ربهم وأولئك هم المفلحون بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم واتبعوا ما تتلو الشياطين على ملك سليمان وما كفر سليمان ولكن الشياطين كفروا يعلمون الناس السحر وما أنزل على الملكين ببابل هاروت وماروت وما يعلمان من أحد حتى
حتى يقولا إنما نحن فتنة فلا تكفر فيتعلمون منهما ما يفرقون به بين المرء وزوجه وما هم بضارين به من أحد إلا بإذن الله ويتعلمون ما يضرهم ولا ينفعهم ولقد علموا لمن اشتراه ما له في الآخرة من خلاق ولبئس ما شروا به أنفسهم لو كانوا يعلمون. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وإلهكم إله واحد لا إله إلا هو الرحمن الرحيم إن في خلق السماوات والأرض واختلاف الليل والنهار والفلك التي تجري في البحر بما ينفع الناس والفلك التي تجري في البحر بما ينفع الناس وما أنزل الله من السماء من ماء فأحيا به الأرض بعد موتها وبث فيها من كل دابة وتصريف الرياح والسحاب المسخر بين السماء والأرض لآيات لقوم يعقلون. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الله لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض من ذا الذي يشفع عنده إلا بإذنه يعلم ما بين أيديهم وما خلفهم ولا يحيطون بشيء من علمه إلا بما شاء وسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض ولا يؤوده حفظهما وهو العلي العظيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا. ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا. ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا. أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. شهد الله أنه لا إله إلا هو والملائكة وأولو العلم قائما بالقسط. لا إله إلا هو العزيز الحكيم. إن الدين عند الله الإسلام وما اختلف الذين أوتوا الكتاب إلا من بعد ما جاءهم العلم بغيا بينهم ومن يكفر بآيات الله فإن الله سريع الحساب. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أفحسبتم أنما خلقناكم عبثا وأنكم إلينا لا ترجعون. فتعالى الله الملك الحق لا إله إلا هو رب العرش الكريم. ومن يدع مع الله إلها آخر لا برهان له به فإنما حسابه عند ربه إنه لا يفلح الكافرون. وَقُلْ رَبِّ اغْفِرْ وَارْحَمْ وَأَنْتَ خَيْرُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ألم تر كيف فعل ربك بأصحاب الفيل. ألم يجعل كيدهم في تضليل وأرسل عليهم طيرا أبابيل ترميهم بحجارة من سجيل فجعلهم كعصف مأكول. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لإيلاف قريش. إيلافهم رحلة الشتاء والصيف. فليعبدوا رب هذا البيت الذي أطعمهم من جوع وآمنهم من خوف. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد
ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد، الله الصمد، لم يلد ولم يولد، ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل أعوذ برب الفلق، من شر ما خلق، ومن شر غاسق إذا وقب، ومن شر النفاثات في العقد، ومن شر حاسد إذا حسد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل أعوذ برب الناس، ملك الناس، إله الناس، من شر الوسواس الخناس، الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس، من الجنة والناس. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. تبارك الذي بيده الملك وهو على كل شيء قدير، الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا، وهو العزيز الغفور. الذي خلق سبع سماوات طباقا، ما ترى في خلق الرحمن من تفاوت، فارجع البصر هل ترى من فتور، ثم ارجع البصر كرتين ينقلب إليك البصر خاسئا وهو حسير. ولقد زينا السماء الدنيا بمصابيح وجعلناها رجوما للشياطين، وأعتدنا لهم عذاب السعير. وللذين كفروا بربهم عذاب جهنم وبئس المصير. إذا ألقوا فيها سمعوا لها شهيقا وهي تفور، تكاد تميز من الغيظ، كلما ألقي فيها فوج سألهم خزنتها ألم يأتكم نذير. قالوا بلى قد جاءنا نذير فكذبنا وقلنا ما نزل الله من شيء إن أنتم إلا في ضلال كبير. وقالوا لو كنا نسمع أو نعقل ما كنا في أصحاب السعير. فاعترفوا بذنبهم فسحقا لأصحاب السعير. إن الذين يخشون ربهم بالغيب لهم مغفرة وأجر كبير. وأسروا قولكم أو اجهروا به إنه عليم بذات الصدور ألا يعلم من خلق وهو اللطيف الخبير هو الذي جعل لكم الأرض ذلولا فامشوا في مناكبها وكلوا من رزقه وإليه النشور أأمنتم من في السماء أن يخسف بكم الأرض فإذا هي تمور أم أمنتم من في السماء أن يرسل عليكم حاصبا فستعلمون كيف نذير ولقد كذب الذين من قبلهم فكيف كان نكير أولم يروا إلى الطير فوقهم صافات ويقبضن ما يمسكهن إلا الرحمن إنه بكل شيء بصير أمن هذا الذي هو جند لكم ينصركم من دون الرحمن إن الكافرون إلا في غرور أمن هذا الذي يرزقكم إن أمسك رزقه بل لجوا في عتو ونفور أفمن يمشي مكبا على وجهه أهدى أمن يمشي سويا على صراط مستقيم قل هو الذي أنشأكم وجعل لكم السمع والأبصار والأفئدة قليلا ما تشكرون قل هو الذي ذرأكم في الأرض وإليه تحشرون ويقولون متى هذا الوعد إن كنتم صادقين قل إنما العلم عند الله وإنما أنا نذير مبين فلما رأوه زلفة سيئت وجوه الذين كفروا وقيل هذا الذي كنتم به تدعون قل أرأيتم إن أهلكني الله ومن معي أو رحمنا فمن يجير الكافرين من عذاب أليم قل هو الرحمن آمنا به وعليه توكلنا فستعلمون من هو في ضلال مبين قل أرأيتم إن أصبح ماؤكم غورا فمن يأتيكم بماء معين
الله رب العالمين
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وما تقدموا لأنفسكم من خير تجدوه عند الله هو خيرا وأعظم أجرا واستغفروا الله إن الله غفور رحيم. أستغفر الله 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 العظيم الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم وأتوب إليه إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما بقدر عظمة ذاتك في كل وقت وحين. فاعلم أنه لا إله إلا الله، 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 لا إله إلا الله سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الذين قال لهم الناس إن الناس قد جمعوا لكم فاخشوهم فزادهم إيمانا وقالوا حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل 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 حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل، 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 حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. فانقلبوا بنعمة من الله وفضل لم يمسسهم سوء واتبعوا رضوان الله والله ذو فضل عظيم. اللهم يا لطيف ألطف بنا فيما جرت به المقادير. اللهم يا لطيف ألطف بنا فيما جرت به المقادير. اللهم يا لطيف ألطف بنا فيما جرت به المقادير. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا علي يا عظيم، يا حليم يا عليم، أنت ربي وعلمك حسبي، فنعم الرب ربي ونعم الحسب حسبي. تنصر من تشاء وأنت العزيز الرحيم. نسألك العصمة في الحركات والسكنات والكلمات والإرادات والخطرات، من الشكوك والظنون والأوهام الساترة للقلوب عن مطالعة الغيوب. فقد ابتلي المؤمنون وزلزلوا زلزالا شديدا، وإذ يقول المنافقون والذين في قلوبهم مرض ما وعدنا الله ورسوله إلا غرورا. فثبتنا وانصرنا وسخر لنا هذا البحر كما سخرت البحر لموسى، وسخرت النار لإبراهيم، وسخرت الجبال والحديد لداود، وسخرت الريح والشياطين والجن لسليمان. وسخر لنا كل بحر هو لك في الأرض والسماء والملك والملكوت، وبحر الدنيا وبحر الآخرة. وسخر لنا كل شيء، يا من بيده ملكوت كل شيء. كافها يا عين صاد، كافها يا عين صاد، كافها يا عين صاد. انصرنا فإنك خير الناصرين، وافتح لنا فإنك خير الفاتحين، واغفر لنا فإنك خير الغافرين،
وارحمنا فإنك خير الراحمين وارزقنا فإنك خير الرازقين واهدنا ونجنا من القوم الظالمين وهب لنا ريحا طيبة كما هي في علمك وانشرها علينا من خزائن رحمتك واحملنا بها حمل الكرامة مع السلامة والعافية في الدين والدنيا والآخرة إنك على كل شيء قدير اللهم يسر لنا أمورنا مع الراحة لقلوبنا وأبداننا والسلامة والعافية في دنيانا ودينينا وكن لنا صاحبا في سفرنا وخليفة في أهلنا واطمس على وجوه أعدائنا وامسخهم على مكانتهم فلا يستطيعون المضي ولا المجيء إلينا ولو نشاء لطمسنا على أعينهم فاستبقوا الصراط فأنى يبصرون ولو نشاء لمسخناهم على مكانتهم فما استطاعوا مضيا ولا يرجعون ياسين والقرآن الحكيم إنك لمن المرسلين على صراط مستقيم تنزيل العزيز الرحيم لتنذر قوما ما أنذر آباؤهم فهم غافلون لقد حق القول على أكثرهم فهم لا يؤمنون إنا جعلنا في أعناقهم أغلالا فهي إلى الأذقان فهم مكمحون وجعلنا من بين أيديهم سدا ومن خلفهم سدا فأغشيناهم فهم لا يبصرون شاهت الوجوه شاهت الوجوه شاهت الوجوه وعنت الوجوه للحي القيوم وقد خاب من حمل ظلما طاسين حاميم عين سين قاف مرج البحرين يلتقيان بينهما برزخ لا يبغيان حاميم 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 هم الأمر وجاء النصر فعلينا لا ينصرون حاميم تنزيل الكتاب من الله العزيز العليم غافر الذنب وقابل التوب شديد العقاب ذي الطول لا إله إلا هو إليه المصير بسم الله بابنا تبارك حيطاننا ياسين سقفنا كاف ها يا عين صاد كفايتنا حميم عين سين قاف حمايتنا فسيكفيكهم الله وهو السميع العليم فسيكفيكهم الله وهو السميع العليم فسيكفيكهم الله وهو السميع العليم ستر العرش مسبول علينا وعين الله ناظرة إلينا بحول الله لا يقدر علينا والله من ورائهم محيط بل هو قرآن مجيد في لوح محفوظ فالله خير حافظا وهو أرحم الراحمين فالله خير حافظا وهو أرحم الراحمين فالله خير حافظا وهو أرحم الراحمين إن وليي الله الذي نزل الكتاب وهو يتولى الصالحين إن وليي الله الذي نزل الكتاب وهو يتولى الصالحين إن وليي الله الذي نزل الكتاب وهو يتولى الصالحين حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم بسم الله الذي لا يضر مع اسمه شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء وهو السميع العليم أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق أعوذ بكلمات الله التامات من شر ما خلق ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم بسم الله والحمد لله رب العالمين
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الله لطيف بعباده يرزق من يشاء وهو القوي العزيز. يا لطيف 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 يا لطيفا بخلقه يا عليما بخلقه يا خبيرا بخلقه ألطف بنا يا لطيف يا عليم يا خبير. يا لطيفا بخلقه يا عليما بخلقه يا خبيرا بخلقه ألطف بنا يا لطيف يا عليم يا خبير. يا لطيفا بخلقه يا عليما بخلقه يا خبيرا بخلقه ألطف بنا يا لطيف يا عليم يا خبير. اللهم يا من لطفت في خلق السماوات والأرض ولطفت بالأجنة في بطون أمهاتها ألطف بنا لطفا يليق بكرمك ورحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين يا الله. اللهم يا من جعلت الصلاة على النبي من القربات نتقرب إليك بكل صلاة سليت عليه من أول النشأة إلى ما لا نهاية من الكمالات. بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يسوق الخير إلا الله. بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يصرف السوء إلا الله. بسم الله ما شاء الله وما بكم من نعمة فمن الله. بسم الله ما شاء الله لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يسوق الخير إلا الله. بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يصرف السوء إلا الله. بسم الله ما شاء الله وما بكم من نعمة فمن الله. بسم الله ما شاء الله لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يسوق الخير إلا الله. بسم الله ما شاء الله لا يصرف السوء إلا الله. بسم الله ما شاء الله وما بكم من نعمة فمن الله. بسم الله ما شاء الله لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك. اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك. اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك. اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك. اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه به في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك. اللهم صل صلاة كاملة وسلم سلاما تاما على سيدنا محمد الذي تنحل به العقد وتنفرج به الكرب وتقضى به الحوائج وتنال به الرغائب وحسن الخواتيم ويستسقى الغمام بوجهه الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه في كل لمحة ونفس بعدد كل معلوم لك.
إن شاء الله we'll continue with ذكر جامعة. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله. لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله في كل لمحة ونفس عدد ما وسعه علم الله إن شاء الله make dua now. اللهم آمين أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for our Shaykh, teacher, murshid, and master, Sayyidina Shaykh Faisal Hamid Abdul Razak. O Allah, may you increase him in knowledge and wisdom. O Allah, may you protect him from evil, and we pray that he will lead his murids on the straight path towards you. O Allah, we pray for the Shaykh and his family. We pray that you strengthen them in Iman, keep them in good health, and grant them long life in Islam. O Allah, we pray that you protect them from all evil, ease their trials, and grant them the sweetness of paradise. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. Allah forgive us for our sins and guide us on the straight path leading to paradise. O Allah, you know the needs of all of us present here. O Allah, answer our dua and take care of our needs. O Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for our parents that you grant them your grace and mercy as they raised us in childhood. O Allah, grant our parents long life and good health in Islam. O Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, forgive our parents and grant them paradise. O Allah, for our parents who have passed away and returned to you, O Allah, we beg you to forgive them. O Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for all the murids of Shaykh Faisal throughout the world. O Allah, we pray that you ease our trials and grant us the strength to face our trials. O Allah, make it easy for us to gain true knowledge and to practice it, to be good murids and to get ever closer to you. O Allah, you know the needs of all of the murids. O Allah, we beg you to answer our dua and take care of our needs. O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for all the Muslims around the world. O Allah, we pray that you strengthen us in Iman. O Allah, we pray for unity and to make us stronger as a nation. O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, please comfort and relieve all Muslims who are suffering and have suffered losses. O Allah, you are the all-powerful and the almighty. O Allah, we beg you to give us victory against the unbelievers. O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we pray for the International Islamic Forum and Al-Fasl al-Dhikr Halaqa. May you make it easy for us to establish many masjids for your sake. May you bless the Islamic Forum and Al-Fasl al-Dhikr Halaqa to be a beacon of light for Islam throughout the world. And may help us to finish building the new masjid soon and make it easy for us to do so. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammadan wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun wa salamun ala al-mursani walhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله سيدنا محمد رسول الله
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم My dear beloved, respected brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum. I want to introduce to you this special book that we've written on the great miraculous event of Al-Isra al-Miraj. The title of the book is Miraj al-Nabi. more than 200 pages of amazing information on this great occasion. This book is available on Amazon. I want to encourage each and every one of you to purchase this book, get your own copy, and I also encourage you to get additional copies for your family members, your relatives, your friends, your loved ones, and give it to them as a gift. Inshallah, they'll benefit from this book, and you'll receive increased blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you, and I wish you enjoyable reading of this great book, Miraj al-Nabi. Assalamu alaikum.
في ليلة تتزيا بالنور والإشراق جبريل جاء النبي يدعه فوق البراق في ليلة تتزيا بالنور والإشراق جبريل جاء النبي يدعه فوق البراق هو النبي الأمين له الصعاب تهون فقوله قول صدق وفعله مأمون في ليلة تتزيا بالنور والإشراق جبريل جاء النبي يده فوق البراق أجب نداء السماء يا سيد الأنبياء يرعك رب البرايا في رحلة الإسراء في ليلة تتزيا بالنور والإشراق جبريل جاء النبي يدعو فوق البراق وحين تم الوصول في القدس صلى الرسول وكان خير رفيق للمصطفى جبريل في ليلة تتزيا بالنور والإشراق جبريل جاء النبي يدعه فوق البراق صلوا على المختار يحات بالأنوار عند الذين ارتجيه قد فاز بالأسرار في ليلة تتزيا بالنور والإشراق جبريل جاء النبي يدعه فوق البراق قد عاد يحمل فرضا خمسا من صلوات ويمنح الأرض فيضا خيرا من بركات في ليلة تتزيا بالنور والإشراق جبريل جاء النبي يدعه فوق البراق وعاد فوق البراق من فوق سبع طباق يدعو لمن صدقوه بالفوز يوم التلاقي في ليلة تتزيا بالنور والإشراق جبريل جاء النبي يدعه فوق البراق في ليلة تتزيا بالنور والإشراق جبريل جاء النبي يدعه فوق البراق
اللهم بارك لنا في رجب وشعبان وبلغنا رمضان 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 اللهم بارك لنا في رجب وشعبان وبلغنا رمضان. 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 اللهم بارك لنا في رجب وشعبان وبلغنا رمضان.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله. اللهم افتح علينا فتوح العارفين، ووفقنا توفيق الصالحين، وانفعنا اللهم بالقرآن والذكر الحكيم. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا، وانفعنا بما علمتنا، وزدنا من فضلك علما وتعليما، يقربنا منك برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم لا سهل إلا ما جعلته سهلا، وأنت يا حي يا قيوم تجعل الحزن إذا شئت سهلا سهلا. اللهم أعزنا من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، وأصلح لنا شأننا كله، لا إله إلا أنت، نستغفرك ونتوب إليك، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. آمين آمين. أما بعد، My dear respected brothers and sisters, my dear murids, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu. May the peace and blessings of God Almighty be with each and every one of you. And welcome once again to our daily broadcast, this special program coming to you from your Zawiya here at the Islamic Forum of Canada, starting at 7 p.m. Toronto time every day. We welcome you to our broadcast today. We thank you for joining us. We hope you can be with us every day at 7 p.m. Toronto time. And we kindly request you to tell others, your family members, your relatives, your friends, other Muslims that you know. Invite them to look at the program, share the YouTube link with them. And inshallah, they'll benefit from looking at the program, and you will receive increased blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember to subscribe to the YouTube channel by clicking on the subscribe button, then like the video, and then click on the bell icon next to the subscribe button to turn on notifications. Select all for notifications so that you'll be notified of all our programs, inshallah. And remind others to subscribe to the channel as well. We want to recognize and thank and make dua for all the sponsors of our dinner program, all those families that have sponsored the dinner program during this month. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of them. We want to recognize and thank and make special dua for all our donors, those who donated today, yesterday, and before, all our donors without exception. We make special dua for them. We pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them, bless their family, all their family members, bless their loved ones because of their donation to the Islamic Forum. We pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase them in their wealth, increase them with His sustenance, with His rizq, and enrich them many more times because of their donation to the Islamic Forum. And I want to make a special appeal to each and every one of you to make a generous donation to the Islamic Forum today. We need your financial support. We make this appeal to you. We hope you will respond positively to this appeal. And to do so, you can go to our website, islamicforumonline.com, to the donation page and select any of the categories of donation that you would like to make a donation for. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. And our staff here at the Islamic Forum will put the link in the chat, type in the link in the chat so you can make a note of it, click on it, and go to the donation page to make your generous donation. Once again, the link is islamicforumonline.com. This program focuses on two main things. First of all, your safety, your security. In these difficult times, in these challenging times, we are concerned about your safety. We make dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, keep you safe and secured, keep you in a state of afiyah, of the best of well-being. And secondly, your spirituality, your closeness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strengthen you in your spirituality, always keep you close to Him and close to His most beloved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We have some special short video clips that our staff here at Islam Forum has prepared for you. These short video clips, there's a series on the seerah of the Prophet ﷺ, and then there's the editor's pick video, special videos prepared for you. And every day we send out one email with the link for the videos, and focusing on the new ones, and then also the details about our daily broadcast, the links for the different programs, the daily lecture, the dhikr majlis, Jum'ah program every Friday starting at 1 p.m. And this is the daily email that we send out to you. And if you're not receiving the email every day, please send us your email address and contact details, including your WhatsApp number. Email it us to the email we use for this program, sheikhfaisal@gmail.com. And once again, our staff here, our hard-working, dedicated, loyal staff, will enter that information, inshallah. I want also to remind you of the special projects or action items we have here. And this is a way for you to be engaged with this program in an interactive way, for you to do specific things that would elevate you spiritually and keep you close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and get you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And there's seven specific projects or action items I want to share with you today. Firstly, the Quran project, and that is to recite one page of the Quran every day. I want you to make your knee and join the Quran project. The Dawah project, for you to invite others to this program. Tell everyone you know about this program, invite them to watch the broadcast, inshallah. This is your Dawah project. Thirdly, the Infaq project, for you to make regular generous donations to the Islam Forum as much as you can, and the blessings are great from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and for you to encourage others to donate to the Islam Forum. That is the Infaq project. Fourthly, the Home Zawiya project, for you to establish your Home Zawiya. And if you need any assistance in so doing, please send us an email and we will facilitate that for you so you can establish your Home Zawiya. But I want each and every one of you to establish your Home Zawiya in your home. That's your Home Zawiya project. Fifthly, the Salawat project, for you to recite as much Salawat as you can on the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and update us in the chat every day, the total for that day and also the cumulative total that you've recited so far since we started the Salawat project. Sixthly, the gratitude project, to express gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to show your gratefulness, your thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the blessings He has bestowed upon you. And seven, the dhikr project. Step one being the word alam that you should recite every day in the morning and in the evening. So twice daily, the word alam project, the dhikr project. And there are several steps of spiritual training in this project. Once you are reciting the word alam every day, twice a day in the morning and the evening, and you'd like to do more, send us an email and we will give you further instructions. So these are the ongoing projects I want to mention to you today. And also now to focus on one of these projects, the infaq project. Infaq meaning to spend in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is from among the greatest virtuous acts of worship that we can engage in for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In fact, in the hereafter, there are people who would beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be sent back in the dunya because they did not live a good life, disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, disbelieve in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, committed evil actions, and then they see the reality in the hereafter, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared for people who disobeyed Him, for punishment, with Jahannam. And then they beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, "Ya Allah, send me back into the dunya so that I can do the good deeds I did not do, like I can worship You," and so on. And the specific thing they mention, the one specific action they mention, is so that they can give sadaqah, they can give charity for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Send them back into the dunya so they can do charity, because they see the benefits, the blessings, the rewards of it. And that's in the hereafter. Obviously, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "Inna kalimatun huwa qailuha wa min wara'ihim barzakhun ila yawmi yub'athun," and so on, that it's a useless word that they're mentioning, that they're not going to get a chance to go back into the dunya. No matter how much they want to do, they beg, no, because they were given their chance. So we must grab hold of this chance that we have now to spend in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before a day comes when there would be no more opportunity to spend for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are many great benefits of infaq that I want to share with you today to encourage you to commit yourself to the infaq project. The first of which is sadaqah. In fact, spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a proof of correctness of iman or faith. The Prophet ﷺ says, "Wasadaqatu burhan," and sadaqah or charity is a proof of iman or faith. It's a proof, dalil, evidence of your faith, the correctness of your faith, the strength of your faith, the sincerity of your faith. The Prophet said, "Wasadaqatu burhan." In fact, the linguistic meaning of sadaqah, it's derived from the verb sadaqah, sad, dal, kaf, sadaqah or sidqa. And it means to be truthful. Sidq, to be truthful. In other words, if you want to be truthful to your faith, your claim of faith, of being a believer, being a Muslim, of having iman, then alayka bis sadaqah, to give sadaqah for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is a proof of faith. Yes, and the word sadaqah is derived from sidq, to be truthful. So to be truthful to your faith, give sadaqah. A proof of your faith, give sadaqah. This is the amazing relationship between the strength of your faith and the proof of your faith, your iman, and sadaqah. To give sadaqah, to show this, to demonstrate this proof of faith. The second benefit I want to share with you today is sadaqah, charity, donation, spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is a cure for illness. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentions in the hadith, "Dawu mardakum bis sadaqah." Achieve a cure for your illness by giving sadaqah. Or receive shifa for your illness or the illness of a family member, a loved one, through sadaqah, by giving sadaqah. You're ill, you give sadaqah. It's a way to achieve shifa, cure from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet said, "Dawu mardakum bis sadaqah." You give sadaqah for that purpose. So for yourself, individually, if you're ill, but then also a family member, your parents, mother, father, your spouse, husband or wife, your children, sons and daughters, your siblings, brothers and sisters, and so on. Family members, loved ones, relatives, friends, people who are ill, and you would like them to get shifa, to get a cure from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you give sadaqah. This is one of the important consequences of giving sadaqah. You gain shifa. So many people are having illness and so on, and they are not getting a cure, then we advise them to give sadaqah, to give donation, charity for Islam, to a cause that's pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet ﷺ mentioned these things, such as the masjid, or the madrasa, Islamic school, and so on. A poor Muslim that you can help like this, you should try to do that as much as you can. Dawu mardakum bisadaqah. There's also something I want to remind you of, and that's what I call the sunnah of the ummah. The sunnah of our Muslim ummah, or Muslim nation, or Muslim community. And perhaps the older ones among us, parents, grandparents, you may remember this, that what your parents, your grandparents would do many years ago. You live in a Muslim community, Muslim country, you would have experienced this, that if someone in the family is ill, your mother or grandmother, they would cook food, and some extra food, cook food for family, and then some extra food, and they'll put it in a container and give it to you to go to your neighbor and give them some extra food. Like this, it's a common practice among Muslims throughout the world, especially, you know, in times gone by. Now, unfortunately, especially in cities, we're losing this practice. People are so busy with other things that they look at medication and so on, which is fine. I'm not opposing that. But what I want to tell you is that the quality of shifa, the quality of cure in the medication, comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ash-shafi, the one who grants you cure, not the medication. The quality of shifa in that medication is placed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because, you know, sometimes two persons are ill with the same symptoms, same illness. The doctors prescribe the same medication to both of them. One of them take it, they feel better. The other one take it, it doesn't feel better. The shifa, the quality of cure, is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In this way. So this is why we follow the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what he taught us to do. And this is among the things that we would do. Like I mentioned, the practice of our parents, grandparents, and so on, they would do this. Someone is ill in the family, they would cook extra food and they would share it to the neighbor, and tell you, small boy, girl, son, granddaughter, like this, you go and give them. My mom send this, my grandmom send this to you, like this. And vice versa. Others would do that. A common practice. And it grants shifa, because the shifa is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You must have this conviction in your heart that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who grants you the cure. You take the asbab, al-akhdhu bil-asbab, in other words, medication, go and see the doctor, and so on and so forth. But always remember to be connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, dawu mardakum bis-sadaqah. Grant cure, or cure your illness by giving sadaqah, by giving donation. The third point I want to mention is, you give sadaqah and you are placed in the shade of Allah's protection. You are placed in the shade of Allah's protection because of your sadaqah. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam says, kullu imri'in fi dhilli sadaqatihi hatta yufsalu bayna an-nas. That everyone is under the shade of his or her sadaqah on the day of judgment until the day judgment is passed, or Yawm al-Qiyamah. And it is so long on that day. Grievous indeed, the conditions on the day of judgment. It's the sun, one of the great signs, major signs of judgment, the sun will come closer to the earth. It get closer, closer. And it becomes so hot, the heat, like you've never imagined. Imagine the direct heat of the sun being close to you. But then the sadaqah that you give in this dunya, the charity, the donation that you give in this dunya, will come in the form of a shade over you, protecting you on the day of judgment, protecting you from the heat of that day, the heat of the sun. And so you'll be comfortable. You'll be comfortable because of the sadaqah you give in this dunya. What a great blessing it has for you, the sadaqah that you give in this dunya. A shade for you on the day of judgment. Among the great blessings of giving sadaqah. So you should strive to give sadaqah as much as you can. Any opportunity you get to give sadaqah, you should do. The Prophet ﷺ tells us of a sadaqah, a type of sadaqah, a type of charity that you can give while you're alive in the dunya, and it continues to benefit you. You continue to receive the blessings even after you die. When you cannot do anything to benefit yourself after you die, the Prophet said, "Idha mat ibn Adam, in qata'at amalahu illa min thalathin." If any one of the children of Adam die, any person, children of Adam, all of humanity, anyone dies, all the action ceases, meaning they cannot do anything for themselves any longer. All the action ceases except for three things. One of them, the Prophet said, sadaqatun jariyah, a recurring charity. This is a category, a special category of charity that you can give, recurring charity, that you gain blessings for while you're alive. But after you die, you continue to gain blessings. You're in your grave and you're getting blessings because of the sadaqah jariyah, recurring charity. What is this recurring charity? It is, for example, to support the masjid, the house of Allah. This is among the greatest examples. Support the masjid, donate to the masjid, house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because people are continuing to benefit every day. Every day people are benefiting from the masjid. Even after you pass away, people continue to benefit from the masjid and you continue to get the blessings. You know, for example, daily live stream broadcast that we're doing, there are countless numbers of people are benefiting from this live stream broadcast, coming to you from the Islamic Forum, this masjid. So many people are benefiting. And when you give that sadaqah, that donation, you share in all of that blessing. There are people, often non-Muslims who take shahada here at the Islamic Forum. You share in the blessings of that. Many things. Because of this program, there are many brothers and sisters in the Quran project are doing khatam of Quran, reciting Quran every day. Many brothers and sisters, you all share in the blessings of that. And it's your donation that allowed this program to continue. It's your donation allow this masjid to continue, this Zawi, this Islamic Forum of Canada to continue. All our television programs, all our broadcasts, all the speeches at international conferences, so many people are benefiting. It is your financial donation and support that allow all of this to happen. So you're sharing all of those blessings, all of those blessings. We have a food bank, for example. Many poor people in need get help from that food bank because of your financial support. That's an example of sadaqah jariyah. Sadaqatun jariyah. Right. Two, be in the shade of your sadaqah on the day of judgment. Allah's protection for you. So this is what I wanted to share with you today. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless each and every one of you, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you to be from among the people who would always be engaged in giving sadaqah for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ameen, ameen, ameen. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. And now, inshallah, we listen to our special lecture for today.
اللهم بارك لنا في رجب وشعبان وبلغنا رمضان 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 اللهم بارك لنا في رجب وشعبان وبلغنا رمضان
جشن آمد رسول
الله الله بی آمنا کے پول
الله الله
جشن آمد رسول
الله الله بی آمنا کے پول
الله الله
جب کے سرکار تشریف لانے لگے پور و دل میں بھی خوشیاں سرکار تشریف لانے لگے پور و دل میں بھی خوشیاں منانے لگے ہر طرف نور کی روشنی چھا گئی ہر طرف نور کی روشنی چھا گئی مصطفیٰ کی امید زندگی مل گئی مصطفیٰ کی امید زندگی
کرنے لگا آمینہ جشن آمد رسول اللهی الله بی بی آمین که پول اللهی الله شادیان خوشی که بجائے گئے شاد کے نغم سب کو سنائے گئے شادیان خوشی کے بجائے گئے شاد کے نغم سب کو سنائے گئے ہر طرف شور صلی
إلا الله لا إله 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 إلا الله سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله اللهم افتح علينا فتوح العارفين ووفقنا توفيق الصالحين وانفعنا اللهم بالقرآن والذكر الحكيم اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا من فضلك علما وتعليما يقربنا منك برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم لا سهل إلا ما جعلته سهلا وانت يا حي يا قيوم تجعل الحزن اذا شئت سهلا سهلا اللهم اعذنا من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا واصلح لنا شاننا كله لا اله الا انت نستغفرك ونتوب اليك ولا حول ولا قوه الا بالله العلي العظيم وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين آمين آمين أما بعد. My dear respected brothers and sisters, I greet you all with the greetings of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu. May the peace and blessings of God Almighty be with each and every one of you. Today we start a new series on the month of Rajab, to say something about the fada'il, the virtues of Rajab and events associated with Rajab. Rajab is a special month. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam describes it as Shahrullah, the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is one of the four sacred months in the Islamic year. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reveals in the Quran, Inna iddata shuhuri inda Allahi thna ashara shahran, that verily the number of months with Allah are 12 on the day He created this universe, four of which are sacred. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala declares in the Quran. And Rajab is one of the sacred months, as explained by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The other three months, they come together one after the other. The last 2 months of the Islamic year and the first month of the new Islamic year. So, Dhul-Qa'dah, Dhul-Hijjah, and then Muharram. Those 3 months that comes consecutively, one after the other, they're the three sacred months together, and then Rajab by itself, making the fourth of the sacred month in the Islamic year. So Rajab is a special month. It is a sacred month described by the Prophet as Shahrullah, the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and it is the seventh month of the Islamic year. It is also the beginning of a special 3 month period of time. The month of Rajab, followed by the month of Sha'ban, followed by the month of Ramadan. And the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam described these 3 months in special ways. The month of Rajab, he says, it is the month of Allah, Shahrullah. And the month of Sha'ban is the month of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Shahrul Rasul. And then the month of Ramadan, Shahrun lil Mu'mineen. It is the month for the believers. So the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, followed by the month of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, followed by the month of the believers. So a special 3 month period of time that starts with Rajab, Al-Murajab, as it is referred to by the scholars of Islam. So this month has many special significances. The high point or pinnacle of this month of Rajab, it is the event of Al-Isra wal-Miraj, which took place on the night of the 27th of Rajab. This is the high point, the acme, the pinnacle of the month of Rajab. Similarly, the month of Sha'ban, its high point is the night of the 15th of Sha'ban, Nisf Sha'ban. And the high point of Ramadan, it is the 27th night of Ramadan, Laylatul Qadr. So in each of these months, there are special events and occasions that took place. Many are the great significant events connected to the month of Rajab. We mentioned the Isra and Miraj, and among which is the birth of Sayyidina Ali in the month of Rajab. And so there are many important things that we should do in this month of Rajab, the month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of the sacred month of the Islamic year, described by the scholars as the nights of this month are called nights of beauty, and the days of this month are called days of brightness. It is also referred to or described as a month of istighfar, the month of fasting, and the month of Mirajun Nabi, among the great virtues and fada'il of the month of Rajab. And so among the things you should do is to exchange greetings for the month of Rajab. And there's a wisdom behind this. The greetings is to say Rajab Mubarak, just as you would say Ramadan Mubarak. and Rabi al-Awwal Mubarak in this way. And this, by doing so, by exchanging greetings, you remind others and remind yourself of this sacred occasion, the sacred month of Rajab, when you say Rajab Mubarak, greetings to someone. And you're reminding them as well of this Mubarak month that is with us, the sacred month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is one of the things I want to recommend for you to do and request you to do, to always strive to exchange Rajab Mubarak greetings during this month of Rajab, and make dua for others that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them in the month of Rajab and accept their dua and so on. Good words in that way as you exchange greetings with others. Also, among the things you should do in this month of Rajab is to perform ghusl at the beginning of the month, whether immediately prior to the start of the month or the first night, first day of the month, whatever is convenient for you. You want to try to perform the full ghusl as you would do for Jum'ah and Eid and other special occasions. And this ghusl that you perform for the niyyah for the month of Rajab, to welcome the month of Rajab, it is to achieve physical purification. And as a result of achieving physical purification, you intend and you hope to achieve spiritual purification in this month of Rajab. There's that important connection between the two things in so many different aspects of the rituals in Islam, the most important of which is the salah that we perform, the five fard salah every day, and then the sunnah and nafil salah and other salah on other times in the day, the different nawafil salah that the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam has taught us to do, such as Salat al-Ishraq immediately after the rising of the sun in the morning, Salat al-Duha in the mid-morning time, Salat al-Awwabin after Maghrib, Salat al-Tahajjud at late night, and so on. Many different salah that we do. Salah is the cornerstone of this religion, Amud al-Islam. And it is a necessary, essential prerequisite for the validity of salah that we be in a state of tahara, of purification. And so when you want to perform your salah, you would make wudu, for example, to ensure that you are in a state of wudu, of purification. And there are some types of uncleanliness, najas, that would require ghusl, that you would perform. And then for special occasions, you would perform ghusl to prepare yourself for that occasion, such as the weekly Eid for the believers, Yawmul Jum'ah. It is from the Sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam that you perform your ghusl for Jum'ah. In a similar way, because of the sacredness of this time, of the month of Rajab, the sacred month of Allah, with all these great virtues, the beginning of a special three-month period of time, Rajab, Sha'ban, Ramadan, and so on, a time when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is most merciful in the month of Allah, in the sacred month, that He bestows His mercy upon you. It is time, it is an opportunity and an opportune occasion for you to prepare yourself to receive this mercy and blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the physical preparation is ghusl for the month of Rajab, to welcome the month of Rajab. And in so doing, the niyyah, the intent, the purpose, you want to achieve spiritual purification as well. The two things go hand in hand, your physical purification so that you can achieve spiritual purification. The fourth thing I want to mention to you of the things to do in Rajab is to perform two rakat of nafil salah in welcoming the month of Rajab. This is a wonderful practice to do. The Prophet ﷺ says in hadith that if you have a need of something that you want to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for, you have a need to beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for something in your life, something important, then he says, perform wudu and perform it well. Perform your wudu well. And then pray 2 rakat nafil salah. And then you make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for whatever you want, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant it to you. So, to perform the 2 rakat of salah, to welcome the month of Rajab, to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless you in this month of Rajab. Pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless you in the month of Rajab. And to pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless the month of Rajab for you. Bless this time for you. Because if the time is blessed for you, it becomes a time of barakah, where you're able to do more and more good deeds. And so this is a great blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If he can grant you barakah in your time, he can bless that time for you. And specifically now, the time of Rajab. You pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, bless the time for you. Let this month be a blessed time for you, that you can do more and more good deeds to get closer and closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then your concern for your family members, your parents, your spouse, your children, your siblings, your entire family, your extended family, your relatives, your friends, your loved ones, the people you're concerned about. This is a time for you to make much dua for them as well. So the 2 rakat nafil salah you perform for this month of Rajab, to welcome the month of Rajab and to pray that this month be a blessed time for you, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you in this month of Rajab, the 2 rakat nafil salah. The 5th thing I want to recommend for you to do in this month of Rajab is to recite some special dhikr and dua, because it is a time of mercy and it is a time to beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His mercy, for His forgiveness, and so on. And among which you should do is the prophetic dua that the Prophet ﷺ would make at this time of Rajab, and connecting this time of Rajab to the following 2 months, so the 3 month period that we're referring to, the dua of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. اللهم بارك لنا في رجب وشعبان وبلغنا رمضان. Oh Allah, bless us in this month of Rajab, and bless us in the month of Sha'ban, and enable us to reach Ramadan, to be alive in Ramadan, and to spend it in a way which is deserving of the month of Ramadan, to spend it in a deserving manner. The month of Ramadan. That's why you want to reach Ramadan, to be alive in Ramadan. Yes. وَبَلِّغْنَا Ramadan, so that we can make the best of that opportunity. As the Prophet ﷺ says, it is the month of freedom from hellfire. He says, unfortunate indeed is that person who is alive in Ramadan and does not gain freedom from hellfire. That's the opportunity for us. So from now, in this month of Rajab, we are connecting to that. We are connecting our well-being in the dunya and in the akhirah to how we are in Rajab, Sha'ban, and Ramadan. So the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam would recite this beautiful dua. And in our daily broadcast on our YouTube channel, we have the special majlis of Rajab or Rajab Mawlid. And this is one of the things we recite every day throughout the month. And you should recite it in cycles of 70 times. Recite it 70 times. The scholars and Ahlul Tasawwuf has mentioned that recommendation for us. So let us recite this beautiful prophetic dua a few times. اللهم بارك لنا في رجب وشعبان وبلغنا رمضان. اللهم بارك لنا في رجب وشعبان وبلغنا رمضان. اللهم بارك لنا في رجب وشعبان وبلغنا رمضان.
اللهم بارك لنا في رجب وشعبان وبلغنا رمضان. اللهم بارك لنا في رجب وشعبان وبلغنا رمضان. اللهم بارك لنا في رجب وشعبان وبلغنا رمضان. اللهم بارك لنا في رجب وشعبان وبلغنا رمضان.
Oh Allah, bless us in this month of Rajab, and bless us in the month of Sha'ban, and enable us to reach Ramadan, to be alive in Ramadan, and to spend it in a deserving manner. Ameen, ameen. The sixth point I want to mention to you today about the things to do in Rajab is another beautiful dhikr and dua that we should recite 70 times every night in this month of Rajab. رَبِّ غْفِرْ لِي وَارْحَمْنِي وَتُبْ عَلَيَّ. O Allah, forgive me, have mercy upon me, and accept my repentance. I turn to you in repentance. I do tawbah to you, Allah. Accept my tawbah, accept my repentance to you, O Allah. So this special dua to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this way, because of the virtues and the special qualities of this month of Rajab and what we can access of benefits and blessings in this month of Rajab. And once again, in our nightly Rajab Mawlid, in the Dhikr Majlis that we do every night for Rajab, this is one of the things we recite 70 times every night on our YouTube channel for the live stream broadcast. We invite you to join us for that on our YouTube channel, youtube.com/Sheikh Faisal, that you can benefit from this great blessing. Let us recite this beautiful dua a few times.
Rabbi ighfir li warhamni wa tub alayya. Rabbi ighfir li warhamni wa tub alayya. Rabbi ighfir li warhamni wa tub alayya. رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي وَارْحَمْنِي وَتُبْ عَلَيَّ. رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي وَارْحَمْنِي وَتُبْ عَلَيَّ. رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي وَارْحَمْنِي وَتُبْ عَلَيَّ. رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي وَارْحَمْنِي وَتُبْ عَلَيَّ.
O Allah, forgive me, have mercy upon me, and accept my repentance. رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي وَارْحَمْنِي وَتُبْ عَلَيَّ. The next point I want to share with you from the things to do that we recommend that you do, these beautiful good deeds for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you can maximize your blessings in this month of Rajab. Another special dhikr that you should recite 70 times every night during this month of Rajab, Al-Murajab, the sacred month of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subbuhun Kuddusun Rabbul Malaikati Warruh. Indeed, holy and most holy is the Lord of the angels, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the Lord of the angels and the spirit Jibreel alayhi salam. This beautiful dhikr that attracts the angels into your presence. Let's recite this a few times.
Subbuhun Kuddusun Rabbul Malaikati Warruh. 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 Subbuhun Kuddusun Rabbul Malaikati Warruh.
Indeed, holy and most holy is the Lord of all the angels and the archangel, the spirit Jibreel alayhi salam, that we recite in this beautiful time during the nights of beauty in this month of Rajab, Al-Murajab. The next item I want to share with you, another beautiful dhikr specifically for the month of Rajab, is taken from the prophetic dua for the 3 month period of time, but a special one for Rajab that we recommend you recite 70 times every night during this month of Rajab. Allahumma barik lana fi Rajab. O Allah, bless us in this month of Rajab. And so let us recite this a few times so we can get a practice to be able to do it every night throughout the month of Rajab, 70 times. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Allahumma barik lana fi Rajab. 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 May Allah bless us in this month of Rajab, a special time indeed for us. There is also a special salah that we should perform in this month of Rajab. Different months have different salah unique for that month that the awliya have recommended. For example, in Ramadan, the unique salah for the month of Ramadan is Salatul Taraweeh that we do only in the month of Ramadan. We don't do Taraweeh in the other month of the year. And in the month of Sha'ban, there is a special salah called Salatul Khair, which we'll explain later on during the month of Sha'ban when we talk about the virtues of Sha'ban. And also in the month of Rajab, there's a special salah that should be performed. It's Salatul Raghaib. Salatul Raghaib that we should perform in this month of Rajab, and especially on the Thursday nights of Rajab, Laylatul Jum'ah, and on the 27th night of Rajab, to perform this special salah called Salatul Raghaib. And there's also the Majlis of Raghaib, Majlis of Raghaib, which is done on the first Thursday night of the month of Rajab, first Laylatul Jum'ah, or on the Thursday nights of the month of Rajab, and also on the 27th night because of the special blessings of the 27th night as well, the occasion of Miraj al-Nabi. And so this is one of the things that we want to recommend for you to do. And we do the special Rajab Mawlid every night throughout the month of Rajab. And we do the live broadcast of it. So wherever you are, anywhere in the world, you can join us on our YouTube channel for the Majlis Raghaib. So do remember to do that. And also on our Facebook page, we have the details and the instructions of how to perform Salatul Raghaib in the special way that it is done. This is a special salah of the granting of wishes. Salatul Raghaib, the granting of wishes, is a prayer of the awliya, and they would recommend that the believers would do this to gain great blessings and extra blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then, among the implications of this month being connected to the following 2 months, the connection of Rajab, Sha'ban, and Ramadan. The scholars have mentioned that the month of Rajab is the month of planting the seeds, meaning the seeds of good deeds. Planting the seeds of good deeds. The month of Sha'ban is the month of watering and cultivating those seeds. And the month of Ramadan is the month of reaping the fruits of those good deeds that you planted in Rajab. Yes. So the month of Allah, followed by the month of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, followed by the month of the believers and for the believers. Rajab, Sha'ban, Ramadan. And then Rajab now described as the time when you plant the seeds of good deeds, that you do this in Rajab now. Plant the seeds of good deeds. Do good deeds in the month of Rajab. And then Sha'ban, you nourish and cultivate it by continuing to do those good deeds.
And then in Ramadan, you reap the benefits, you harvest the benefits, the fruits of those good deeds that you planted in Rajab. It's an amazing connection. Because of this, the scholars have said that if you want to know how you will be in Ramadan, look to how you are in Rajab. Yes. Not all Ramadan, months of Ramadan, different years are the same for people. Sometimes it's better than others. And the secret is how you are in Rajab. So you want to push yourself a little more and more. Push yourself to do good deeds for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do that extra salah. Do that extra recitation of Quran. Extra dhikr, extra dua. In fact, spending in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, push yourself to do a little more in Rajab. Because then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant you tawfiq to do more in Shaban and to really reach the climax in Ramadan. Yes. If you want to know how you will be in Ramadan, look to how you are in Rajab. Now is the time to plant the seeds of good deeds. And also among the great fada'il, virtues of this month of Rajab, is its connection to Sayyidina al-Imam Ali, karramallahu wajhahu wa alayhi salam. Sayyidina Imam Ali ibn Abi Talib, alayhi salam, was born on the 13th of Rajab, in the year 24 before the Hijrah. And he passed away on the 20th of Ramadan in the year 40 after the Hijrah. And his birth is an amazing, unique occasion and event. His mother, Sayyida Fatima bint al-Asad, her name was also Fatima, radiallahu anha, the mother of Sayyidina Ali. She was pregnant with him. And towards the end of that period of gestation or pregnancy, she was one day performing tawaf around the Kaaba, pregnant with Sayyidina Ali, the baby. And she started experiencing labor pains. And she didn't know what to do, and she turned to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect her and cover her up so that she doesn't deliver baby in front of everyone in public. She's there at the Kaaba. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened the door of the Kaaba for her, and she entered into the Kaaba and delivered Sayyidina Ali inside the Kaaba. This is a unique blessing for Sayyidina Ali, the only person that was born inside the Kaaba. And he was born in the month of Rajab. And inshallah, we pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us tawfiq to say more about him as we continue the series of Rajab, series of lectures. One of the things I want to mention to you from the gems of wisdom of Sayyidina al-Imam Ali alayhi salam, he says, لا تنظر إلى من قال ولكن انظر إلى ما قال. Do not look to who said it, but look at what is said. It's a wonderful point of wisdom for us to benefit from. Sometimes people look at the person who is saying something and decide whether to accept or reject it because of how they feel about that person. If they don't like that person, they won't accept anything, even though the person is saying something good. So he tells us, no, don't bother with who's saying it, but consider what is being said. And if it's something good, you accept it. If it's something good that can benefit you, you take that benefit. Yes. As the saying goes, wisdom is the lost property of the believer. Like wisdom, wherever you find it, you take it. It's like your lost property. You find something that you've lost, you grab hold of it right away and keep it safely. Wisdom is like that for the believer that you should be mindful of. So many are the great wisdom of Sayyidina Imam Ali that we'll share with you as we continue the series of lectures on Rajab al-Murajab, on the virtues of Rajab. And among the great events which took place in this month of Rajab,
is the miraculous event of Al-Isra wal-Mi'raj, or Mi'raj al-Nabi. The month of Rajab, it's also referred to as the Shahrul Istighfar, the month of forgiveness, the month of forgiveness. And I want to conclude our lecture for today with another gem from Sayyidina Imam Ali, Imam Ali that's connected to the month of Rajab. Sayyidina Imam Ali, karamallahu wajhahu, said, "It puzzles me that a man should perish when he possesses the means to save himself." And when the people asked him to explain this, he said, "The prayer for forgiveness, to seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." He says, "It puzzles me that a man should perish when he possesses the means to save himself." And when the people asked him to explain, he said, "The prayer for forgiveness. That is what would save you from being perished, save you from the path of destruction." Yes, that we should be mindful of, among the beautiful gems of wisdom from Sayyidina Imam Ali, karamallahu wajhahu wa alayhi salam, who was born in this great sacred month of Rajab al-Murajab. I pray Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you with his special blessings in this great month of Allah, the sacred month of Allah, Rajab al-Murajab. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you in this month. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless this month for you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless your entire family, your loved ones. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shower his forgiveness and his mercies on you in this month of Allah. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to be closer and closer to him, and closer to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Ameen, ameen, ameen. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in wa akhir da'wana an alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
في ليلة تتزيا بالنور والإشراق، جبريل جاء النبي يدعه فوق البراق. في ليلة تتزيا بالنور والإشراق، جبريل جاء النبي يدعه فوق البراق. هو النبي الأمين له صعاب تهون، فقوله قول صدق وفعله مأمون. في ليلة تتزيا بالنور والإشراق، جبريل جاء النبي يده فوق البراق. أجب نداء السماء يا سيد الأنبياء، يرعك رب البرايا في رحلة الإسراء. في ليلة تتزيا بالنور والإشراق، جبريل جاء النبي يدعو فوق البراق. وحين تم الوصول في القدس صلى الرسول، وكان خير رفيق للمصطفى جبريل. في ليلة تتزيا بالنور والإشراق، جبريل جاء النبي يده فوق البراق صلوا على المختار يحت بالأنوار عند الذين ارتجيه قد فاز بالأسرار في ليلة تتزيا بالنور والإشراق جبريل جاء النبي يدعه فوق البراق قد عاد يحمل فرضا خمسا من صلوات ويمنح الأرض فيضا خيرا من بركات في ليلة تتزيا بالنور والإشراق جبريل جاء النبي يدعو فوق البراق وعاد فوق البراق من فوق سبع انتباق يدعو لمن صدقوه بالفوز يوم التلاقي في ليلة تتزيا بالنور والإشراق جبريل جاء النبي يدعه فوق البراق في ليلة تتزيا بالنور والإشراق جبريل جاء النبي يدعه فوق البراق
جشن آمد رسول
الله الله بی بی آمینہ کے پول
الله الله
جشن آمد رسول
الله الله
بی بی آمینہ کے پول
الله الله
جب کے سرکار تشریف لانے لگے گرو غلما بھی خوشیاں سرکار تشریف لانے لگے حور و غلمان کی خوشیاں منانے لگے ہر طرف نور کی روشنی چھا گئی ہر طرف نور کی روشنی چھا گئی مصطفیٰ کی امید زندگی مل گئی مصطفیٰ کی امید زندگی
سب کو سنائے گئے
فاذكر لا تخشى الملل لا إله إلا الدنيا وفي الأخرى على الأذكار أجرى. لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، لا إله إلا الله، محمد رسول الله عليه صلاة الله، لا تغفل عنها ولا تترك تنزيها.
الصلاة والسلام عليك يا حبيب الله، الصلاة النقطة بمدى الزمن الشاذني وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى
الروح له أدنى ثمن قد اللقطة بمدى الزمن الشاذني وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى الروح له أدنى ثمن قد دل على المولى وسما في الفضل إلى أعلى كنن قد دل على المولى وسما في الفضل إلى أعلى كنن وذا في هذا العلم بما قد زاد على أبهى فدني قد كل قطاب مدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى الروح له أدنى ثمن معرفة المولى رايته فاتبعه على هذا السنن معرفة المولى غايته فاتبعه على هذا السنن ورسول الله وسيلته فاغرف من هاتيك السنن قد كل خطاب مدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى الروح له أدنى ثمن وأساس بناء طريقته تطهير القلب من الدرن وأساس بناء طريقته تطهير القلب من الدرن فاسلك بالاسم المفرد يا صوفي وبالحق استعن قد كل قطاب مدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى الروح له أدنى ثمن غب وافن عن الأكوان فما يبقى إلا من فيه فني غب وافن عن الأكوان فما يبقى إلا من فيه فني وادخل أبواب الغيب وسل ما شئت وللأسرار سني قد كل قطاب مدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى الروح له أدنى ثمن واشرب كأس العرفان وذق سر التوحيد ولا تكن واشرب كأس العرفان وذق سر التوحيد ولا تكن وبحب رجال الله فدل وإمام الكل أبي الحسن قد كل قطاب مدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار إمام هدى الروح له أدنى ثمن والزم عتابا طاهرة إن جئت ميثرة الوطن والزم عتابا طاهرة إن جئت ميثرة الوطن وبعيدة بالكف وتمرق ولروحك في القبر ارتهني قل قطابي
الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار ما مودى أروه له أدنى ثمن قطب الأقطاب مدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار ما مودى أروه له أدنى ثمن وابذل يعقوب جاهلا دعوى في أثواب الكفن وابذل يعقوب جاهلا دعوى في أثواب الكفن فقف يا مولاي عليه وعلينا جمعا بالمنن وكل المطاب مدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار ما مهدى أروه له أدنى ثمن قطب الأقطاب مدى الزمن الشاذلي وابو الحسن بحر الأسرار ما مهدى أروه له أدنى ثمن أروه له أدنى ثمن أروه له
مصطفى بلغ ما قصيدنا
واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم
يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ ما قصيدنا
واغفر لنا ما مضى يا واسع الكرم يا أكرم الخلق ما لمن علو
يا ربي بالمصطفى بلغ مقاصدنا
صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها
صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها
صلى الله على طه خير الخلق وأحلاها
صلى
لا إله إلا الله صلوا
على رسول الله محمد أشرف العرب والعجم محمد خير من يمشي على قدمي محمد بسيط المعروف جامعه محمد صاحب الإحسان والكرم لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله محمد تاج رسل الله قاطبة محمد صادق الأقوال والكلم محمد ثابت الميثاق حافظه محمد طيب الأخلاق والشيم لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله محمد جبلت بالنور تينته محمد لم يزل نورا من القدم محمد حكيم بالعدل ذو شرف محمد مدين الإنعام والحكم لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله محمد خير خلق الله من مضر محمد خير رسل الله كلهم محمد دينه حق ندين به محمد مشرك حقا على عالم لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله محمد ذكره روح لأنفسنا محمد شكره فرض على الأمم محمد رحم الله العباد به محمد سبب الإنشاء من عدم لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله لا إله إلا الله صلوا على رسول الله.
في ليلة تتزيى بالنور والإشراق جبريل جاء النبي يدعه فوق البراق في ليلة تتزيى بالنور والإشراق جبريل جاء النبي يدعه فوق البراق هو النبي الأمين له صعاب تهون
فقوله قول صدق وفعله مأمون في ليلة تتزيا بالنور والإشراق جبريل جاء النبي يده فوق البراق أجب نداء السماء يا سيد الأنبياء يرعك رب البرايا في رحلة الإسراء في ليلة تتزيا بالنور والإشراق جبريل جاء النبي يدعو فوق البراق وحين تم الوصول في القدس صلى الرسول وكان خير رفيق للمصطفى جبريل في ليلة تتزيا بالنور والإشراق جبريل جاء النبي يدعو فوق البراق صلوا على المختار يحات بالأنوار عند الذين ارتجيه قد فاز بالأسرار في ليلة تتزيا بالنور والإشراق جبريل جاء النبي يدعه فوق البراق قد عاد يحمل فرضا خمسا من صلوات ويمنح الأرض فيضا خيرا من بركات في ليلة تتزيا بالنور والإشراق جبريل جاء النبي يدعو فوق البراق وعاد فوق البراق من فوق سبع طباق يدعو لمن صدقوه بالفوز يوم التلاقي في ليلة تتزيا بالنور والإشراق جبريل جاء النبي يدعه فوق البراق في ليلة تتزيا بالنور والإشراق جبريل جاء النبي يدعه فوق البراق
جشن آمد رسول
الله الله بيبي آمنا کے پول
الله الله
جشن آمد رسول
الله الله بيبي آمنا کے پول
الله الله
جب کے سرکار تشریف لانے لگے پورو غلما بھی خوشیاں
سرکار تشریف لانے لگے پورو غلما بھی خوشیاں منانے لگے
ہر طرف نور کی روشنی چھا گئی
ہر طرف نور کی روشنی چھا گئی
مصطفیٰ کی امید زندگی مل گئی
مصطفیٰ کی امید زندگی
تعریف کرنے لگا کوئی زلفوں کی تعریف
على آله وأصحابه أجمعين. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد عبد الله ورسوله. أما بعد، my dear respected beloved brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu. May the peace and blessings of Almighty Allah be with each and every one of you, and welcome once again to our daily live stream broadcast coming to you from your Zawiya here at the Islamic Forum of Canada. We thank you for joining us tonight on this wonderful Wednesday evening, the 28th night of Jumada Thaniya, the 10th day of January. Thanks for joining us. We hope you can join us every day at 7 p.m. Toronto time, the start time of the program. And kindly reach out to your family members, your relatives, your friends, and other Muslims you know. Tell them about this program. Encourage them to watch the program and sign into the chat. Inshallah, they'll benefit from the program. You'll receive increased blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So thanks for being with us. Alhamdulillah. I want to remind you of the special upcoming programs. The Miraj Nabi program would be Wednesday night, the 7th of February, inshallah. That's the 27th night of Rajab, Wednesday night, 7th of February. And then the Nisf Shaban program will be on Saturday night, the 14th of February. Saturday night, the 14th of February. So, Sorry, it's the 24th, the 24th of February for the Nisf Shaban program, corresponding to the 15th night of the Shaban. And then the Welcome to Ramadan dinner will be on the 9th of March, inshallah. So please be mindful of those dates so you can prepare for those dates and be with us here at the Islamic Forum, inshallah. Do remember to sign into the chat with your updates and so on. And click on the thumbs up button to like the program. And you type in the chat, Ameen, for the dua when we make the dua to end, inshallah. And do remember the book that featuring, it's the Miraj Nabi book. Alhamdulillah. So Sis Abidans is Shamal from Manchester in the United Kingdom. They are studying the book with their students at the Muslim Academy in Manchester. And also the brothers there, their brother Sidi Saeed, they're also teaching it to the brothers as well. So Alhamdulillah, we encourage all of you to do so. Siti Marim is also teaching the book to her students. And We recommend that you all do so, teach this book, study this book, the Miraj Nabi book, inshallah, as we will be starting the season of Miraj soon enough. Alhamdulillah. Sister Sara Jaradat asks a question about acid reflux. One of the things that I would suggest, which I did not suggest before, it is to use probiotic. They have the capsules selling in the health store. Select good quality. Fenestra is usually a good quality of probiotic. And make sure you get the vegetable capsule, not the gelatin capsule, inshallah. And use that. It will help you in this condition that you mentioned. I thought I should include that suggestion as well. So hopefully from among the things I'm suggesting, there are things that would work for you. At the top of the chat, there are several messages from the admin staff. Please go through those messages so you can respond accordingly. To remind about the Islam school program, we have our full-time school Monday to Friday up to grade 8, and the part-time school on weekend up to grade 12. So those in the Metro Toronto, Greater Toronto area can bring their children, students to the Islam school and register them. And a good time to bring them would be on Saturday after 10 a.m. Inshallah, to register, and we request everyone to support the school program. The appeal for the new masjid construction, an opportunity for you to get great blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and have a home, a dream home, a mansion built for you in Jannah. And our feature book once again is Miraj and Nabi. At the top of the chat today, number one, we have Sidi Sharif Al-Faisal saying, Jamadath and family from Scarborough, welcome. Jamadath and Mubarak greetings, Maulid Mubarak greetings, Umar Mubarak greetings, Happy New Year Mubarak greetings. To our note prayers by Blessed Sayyidina Sheikh Faisal, our peers and family, Murid's admin staff, and IFC family. Alhamdulillah. Second in chat today, we have Siti Shivan Dubey, Siti Halima Khan Dubey, and the entire family from Ajax. Wishing Jamadath Thani Mubarak greetings, Maulid Mubarak greetings, Umar Mubarak greetings, your beloved Faisal, Sayyidina Sheikh Faisal, your beloved no parents and family, fellow Murid's admin staff, and IFC family. Shukran, both of you, for your complete greetings. Alhamdulillah. Third in chat today, we have this is Bibi Ibrahim, Brother Mohammed Ibrahim and family from Pembroke Pines in the United States, welcome. Says grateful to our Sheikh Sheikh Faiz for the daily blessed informative programs. Alhamdulillah, thanks for your feedback. May Allah bless you. Fourth in chat today, we have Brother Mohammed Feroz and family from Mississauga. Welcome, Alhamdulillah. Thanks for joining us. Sister Sarja Rada from Richmond Hill. Wishing Jumadath and Mubarak greetings to the IFC family. May Allah bless them, Sheikh Faisal and his family. May Allah bless the IFC family. Ameen. And to you as well. May Allah bless you, Sister Sarah, and your family. May Allah grant you Shifa and Taman. So I hope you heard my the comment about your situation and that you can use the probiotic capsules that are available from the health stores. Select a good quality, good brand name. Finestra is what we recommend. It's supposed to be good one, a good quality one. And you use those capsules, vegetable capsule once again, not gelatin. Inshallah, that would give you much relief for your condition. Sister Abidan, Sister Shamaila and family from Manchester, United Kingdom. Thanks for your message, you got your message. Recite the forges of the Quran today in 25,000 salawat. We're grateful for the upcoming blessed month of Rajab. So tonight in our lecture, we featured that special lecture about Rajab. Rajab is a special time. So to help you to prepare for this great sacred month of Rajab, inshallah. So we hope all of you can do so. And by studying this Miraj al-Nabi book, it would help you tremendously. So we want to encourage all of you, get your book. From Amazon, the link is in the chat. Inshallah, get additional copies. A good gift for you to give to your loved ones. You know, the many people, they give gifts sometimes. This is from the Sunnah. The Prophet says, Tahadu, Tahabu. So you exchange gifts, give to your loved ones. But the best of gift is a good Islamic book, and the ones that we've written is the one ones we recommend. You know, it is said that your best companion is a good book, and the books that we've written are meant for that. So spread the word. Siti Razia Khan, Siti Tariq from Scarborough, welcome. Siti Yasmin from Bowmanville, welcome. Wishing Jamadath and Mubarak Green, Sayyidina Sheikh Faiz, Bilal Prince and family, IFC family, Alhamdulillah, Shukran. Fellow Murids, very good. Thanks, Siti Razia. Alhamdulillah. So for everyone, do be mindful with the dates of the three special programs that are coming up soon, inshallah, that you can prepared to come to the Islamic Forum for those programs. So Safar Chuktai and the family from Mississauga, welcome. Alhamdulillah, Brother Khurshid Anwar and family, all of you, welcome. Thanks for joining us, alhamdulillah. Continue to reach out to other Muslims and tell them about the program, inshallah, about this program that they can all watch it. Siti Maram Jamil Faisal, Siti Bilal, Siti Elijah from Richmond, Virginia, in the United States, welcome. Wishing Jamal Athani Mubarak greetings, Malubar greetings, Umar Mubarak greetings, Niyar Mubarak greetings, your beloved Faisal, Sayyidina Sheikh Faisal, and your beloved no parents and family, fellow Murids, admin staff, and TFC family. Shukran Siti Maryam for your company greetings. Remembering everyone, mention my parents and family, Allah SWT bless you, bless the entire family. And Siti Maryam sends special salams and happy birthday greetings to my dad, Al-Hajj Imam Abdul Hamid Abdul Razak. Shukran Siti Maryam. And Siti Maryam make dua for the admin staff for welcome everyone to the Garden of Jannah tonight. This is Bibi Farida Babs and Omar from Pembroke Pines in the United States. Welcome. Grateful Sheikh Faiz for the blessed dua and daily program. Shukran, alhamdulillah. Thanks for your feedback. May Allah bless you. Siti Shazia Wan from Manchester, United Kingdom. Welcome. Alhamdulillah. Siti Maryam giving feedback on Surat al-Mulk. Siti Rabia Lunat and family from North California. Welcome. Alhamdulillah. Thanks for joining us. Sister Brenda Williams and family from Harlem, New York, in the United States, welcome. Shin Jamaat Athan Mubarak greetings and FC family, grateful for this blessed live stream broadcast and spiritual guidance. Salawat today, 2100 for a total of 15,000 for the year so far. Quran Project of Surah number 3, very nice. Great progress, and we thank you, Sister Brenda Williams, for your frequent, generous donations. It is not for me, Allah SWT, enrich you many more times. Alhamdulillah. As we make dua for all our donors. Siti Arif Muhammad from New York, United States, welcome. Wishing Jamaat Athan Mubarak greetings to the entire Sikh family. Alhamdulillah. I recited Wird Alam twice today and two pages of the Quran for Quran project. Very good. Grateful to Allah for his guidance. Alhamdulillah. Shukran Siti Arif, may Allah bless you more and more. Siti Zahara from Alabama in the United States, welcome. Jamaat Athan Mubarak greetings, Maulid Mubarak greetings, Om Mubarak greetings, Happy New Year Mubarak greetings to Bila Faisal, Sayyidina Sheikh Faisal, Bila Abu Noor, Prince and family, Fel Muriz, admin staff, entire Sikh family. Shukran. Sister Bibi Zamino Razak and family from Cotton Tree Village, West Coast, Barbie, St. Guyana, South America. Welcome, Alhamdulillah. Thanks for joining us from Guyana, from South America. Please tell all the Muslims there about this program, encourage them to watch the program. And Siti Maryam, again, happy birthday greetings to her husband, Siti Bilal. So special birthday greetings to Siti Bilal. May Allah SWT bless you on your special day, and we request everyone to type in the chat, happy birthday greetings to Siti Bilal Al-Faisal. Siti Roxana Begum family from Brampton, welcome. Alhamdulillah, we said 3,000 salawat today for 28,000 for the year so far. Make dua for you and your family and for Shifa, inshallah. Siti Tariq Firoz, welcome. Brother Fazil Muhammad and family, welcome. And Siti Tariq, make dua for all those you're requesting dua for. Contact them, give them your salams, and tell you make dua for them. Sister Shamin Subhani from Balmain and Kuva in Trinidad in the West Indies. Welcome. Sister Shamin Subhani, thanks for joining us tonight. We hope you can join us every night, inshallah, 7 p.m. start time of the program. Give our salams to everyone there, inshallah. Sister Shireen Jabbar and family from Ottawa, welcome. Alhamdulillah. Brother Ahsan Shabir and family from Italy, welcome all the way from Italy. Make the for you, your family, your parents is requested, inshallah. And Siti Maryam says, grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for you, Sayyidina Sheikh Faisal, and his blessed and this blessed lecture tonight as we prepare to welcome the sacred month of Rajab, Shaban, Ramadan. Alhamdulillah. Sister Bibi Rasool and family from Etobicoke, welcome. Make dua for you and your family's request, inshallah. Give them all our salams and tell me make dua for them. Wishing Jumaatan Mubarak greetings, Maulana Mubarak greetings, Om Mubarak greetings to Sayyidina Sheikh Faiz, your parents and family, IFC family, Shukran. Asid Maram says, gratitude project of tranquility and humbled heart before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Deepen the disconnect and remain in a state of spiritual purity and worship to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during the sacred time. Quran project of the surah number 2, Salawat for 2,000 for 30,000 for the year so far. We started Weird Alama for Fajr and Nafil Maghrib. We said the Rukya verses in the first segment of election broadcast. Performed 2 rakat Nafil Salah. We said Hizbul. Husband Allah Dikir and Knut Nazila for Palestine, inshallah, mashallah. Very nice work. Keep up the great work. And from Sidi Bilal, Quran project, pursuing a 7 Salawat project, 2,000 today for a total of 30,000 for the year so far. We said, Weird Alam of Fajr after the Maghrib, the Rukh verses in the first segment of the live stream broadcast. Performed 2 rakat Nafil Salah. We said, his husband Allah and Knut Nazila for Palestine. Very good. Alhamdulillah. And Sid Maran says, make near foot fast tomorrow. So tomorrow, Thursday, we request everyone to fast, inshallah. It's a sunnah fast, and also to include your near foot fast for our brothers and sisters in Palestine. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them victory. Siti Shahs Fakhatri and family from Orange County in the United States, welcome. Salawat project 10,000 today for a total of 28,000 for the year so far. Very nice. We said Weird Alam twice today. Quran project of Surah Al-Kahf. Very good. Alhamdulillah, keep up the wonderful work and continue to reach out to everyone you know and tell them to watch the program. And Sister Sarah Jorad says, Your Eminence, thank you so much for your response to my question. Yes, it eased my worries. I really want to try the natural medicine that you suggested. So for the other things, I would suggest you start at a low amount, low quantity, not too much. So that your body would ease into it. It's easier for the body to accept it when it's low quantity, inshallah. And of course, the organic honey, organic black seed, and I mentioned today the probiotic capsules that you should get, that specific brand. In the health stores, they should have them, Finestra. Run inshallah. It's a good quality. So you get good quality product, organic, but start with very small quantity, so the body gets a chance to adapt it, inshallah. But these things would help tremendously. You know, initially it may not help, you may not see any improvement, but persist in doing it. There is actually a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in which. A mother came to the Prophet and complained about her son having lots of stomach problems. And the Prophet told her to use honey. She did that. After a few days, she came back, short time after, and said that it wasn't working. So the Prophet will continue doing it, that the shifa of the honey is truthful, and the stomach is lying. What meaning that? Persist in doing it. Don't, you know, try it in for just the first time or second time and say it's not working and leave it off. Keep doing it and it would help, inshallah. So in small amounts, once again. So it's easier for the body to deal with it. Red Mustafa Bashiruddin, Sister Zarina Bashiruddin, for Markham, welcome. We make dua for you and for your late dad as well. Alhamdulillah. So we did that lecture for more recent France. Siti Marm is asking the importance to self in the life of a Muslim. It's we have the recording of the lecture and we are editing it. So later on we'll receive these. It may take some time because we're busy with so many things, but it has to be edited. It was meant for the Maurice in France. I wanted to do a special program for them. Siti Marzana Tasmin and family from Oshawa, welcome, alhamdulillah. Thanks for joining us. Siti Sharifa Faisal from Scarborough, welcome, says, dear Sayyid Nasheh, grateful for the lecture this evening, especially on welcoming the month of Rajab and Murajab. Quran Project Surah Tour, performed two rakat, Nafil Salah of Sheikh Instruction, Tahajjud Salah for Palestine. Very good, Siti Sharif. Keep up the good work, inshallah. And make a note of the three upcoming program for Miraj Nabi, for Nisf Shaban, and for Ramadan Dinner. So you can plan to be here at the Islamic Forum, inshallah. And tell everyone you know about these programs. Siti Razia Khan, Quran Project of Surah number 3, Salawat 500 today for a total of 4,500 for years so far. Very good progress, inshallah. Keep up the good work. And Siti Razia has a probiotic recommendation, is very good for the acid reflux problem. Thank you, Sheikh. Yeah, alhamdulillah, you keep doing this, inshallah. I mean, the yogurt has a similar effect, but the probiotic capsule is more concentrated. Like you get it, it is a stronger dose, so it gives you more relief. But for those of you who can use yogurt, you should use it regularly, inshallah. It helps. It has a lot of good benefits. And by the way, in passing, I just want to recommend castor oil for you to use for external application. It has a lot of benefits. Inshallah, some other time we'll talk about it. Sister Bibrasul making dua for the admin staff for the hard work. Alhamdulillah, we request all of you to make dua for the admin staff. They do hard work, great work, very committed. May Allah bless them. And Siti Marm says, dear admin staff, I really appreciate and thank you for the beautiful pictures during the Qasidas, playing such beautiful creation of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala is praiseworthy and most glorious. Alhamdulillah, and we want to, specifically for those things, we thank Sayyid Muzammil for his creative work, inshallah, that you mentioned. Shukran Siti Marm for your feedback. Siti Razia Khan says, the lecture tonight is very important, informative, getting closer to the blessed month of Ramadan, alhamdulillah. Shukran, we hope you can all prepare earnestly. And the best way of preparation is to be with this program regularly. Make it a daily schedule, inshallah. Siti Razia says, happy birthday to Siti Bilal Faisal. So Siti Bilal, the husband of Siti Marim, is his birthday. So we request all of you to wish him happy birthday, inshallah. Siti Bilal Faisal. Siti Bibrasul wishing happy birthday to Siti Bilal and to my dad, his birthday in this month of January. And Siti Bibrasul says she fasts tomorrow. She make dua that everyone can fast tomorrow, the entire IFC family. So we hope you can all fast tomorrow, inshallah. It's very good. So Sidbir was asking, where can she get the probiotic tablet? So you go to the health store, mostly the health store would have it, and you can ask someone there to show you, one of the employees, for a probiotic, or you can search on the shelf for probiotic. In many of the health store, that section is arranged alphabetically, the different tablets and capsules. So you go through it and look for P probiotic, it will be there, inshallah. It's very good for many things, many health issues. It's good to use, inshallah. It helps with strengthening the stomach. And the Prophet ﷺ says that most of the diseases, most of the illnesses, the source of it is the stomach. Yeah. So if you can have a good stomach and so on, then it helps you in your health, inshallah. Sitenisa Khan and family from Ottawa, welcome. Wishing Jumada Thani Mubarak greetings, Happy New Year Mubarak greetings. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you, Sayyidina Sheikh, for all the work you do for the Ummah. The weather is better today in Ottawa, alhamdulillah. Yes, it's also better here in Toronto. Yesterday was very bad. Yeah. We hope we get good weather. But now it's winter time, so we should be prepared for these different conditions. Yeah, it's better in Toronto. And Sister Jorad, thank you so much, Your Eminence, Sheikh Faisal. Sister Birusu says, I use honey, ginger, and I blend the black seed in powder because I'm not able to drink the oil. Yeah, so you can get the actual black seed and you blend it in, inshallah. It's very helpful. The Prophet Ali Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says in hadith that black seed is a cure for every disease except death, because no one can escape death. But in terms of your disease, you may get black seed is good. So try to use it regularly, everyone. Whether you're sick or not, it's a good preventative care for you. And Sid Martin says, I'm planning a Ramadan dinner. You should do that, and you know, for the Sunday Dhikr Halika, you try to encourage the sisters. Let Sidi Bilal encourage your brothers to come. And you know, you can plan that get together often, so they get accustomed to gathering together and do the Dhikr with you. And of course, those that are living far away in other states and so on, you do that online for them, inshallah. Sabir Rasool, I'm not sure if you're using Buckley's. Maybe you should try Buckley's if you're not using it. Use it regularly, inshallah. And Cesar conveying happy birthday greetings to Bilal. So, alhamdulillah. So, Siti Maran, please tell Siti Bilal, everyone is wishing him happy birthday, inshallah. Alhamdulillah, those are the brothers and sisters in the chat. We make dua now for everyone in the chat, first and foremost, for taking the extra time and effort to engage with the program. We encourage all of you to do so. You know, click on the thumbs up button to like the program. You should all do that now. And then make sure every night you sign into the program in the chat, and then you type Ameen in the chat for the dua. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase your blessings. We make dua for everyone watching the program. We make dua for the entire IFC family, wherever they are, in different cities, different countries. We make dua for all of them, inshallah. We make dua for all our donors, those that donated today, yesterday, and before. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless all of them. And we've been sending out personalized emails to each and every one of you for the thank you for donations, and also the appeal for the end of year, last year 2023, and a new year 2024. Special appeal that you can all make your pledges, inshallah. We make dua for Palestine and the brothers and sisters there. South Africa, the government of South Africa has done a very courageous thing. They've taken the Palestine issue to the International Court of Justice. So make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them success in this case, inshallah. Special love for each and every one of you. Kindly raise your hands and join me in dua. Allahumma ameen. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إنا كنا من الظالمين. حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل، حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل، حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. اللهم اهدنا في من هديت، وعافنا في من عافيت، وتولنا في من توليت، وبارك لنا فيما أعطيت، وقنا برحمتك واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت، فإنك تقضي ولا يقضى عليك، وإنه لا يذل من واليت ولا يعز من عاديت. تباركت ربنا وتعاليت، فلك الحمد على ما قضيت، نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. وصلى الله تعالى على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله، سيدنا محمد رسول الله. اللهم آمين آمين آمين. Do remember to type Ameen in the chat for the dua. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept your dua and increase your blessings. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase in tawfiq and kubul and ziyad. We thank you for joining us today for the program on this 28th night of Jumada Thaniya, the 10th day of January. We hope you can join us every day, inshallah, at 7 p.m. Toronto time, the start time of the program. Alhamdulillah. Siti Razia saying Ameen to the Dua, Alhamdulillah. Siti Tark Bordi as well. Rasan Shabri saying Ameen to the Dua. Siti Maram Jamil Faiz is saying Ameen to the Dua. Siti Marzan, Siti Marzan at Tasmin saying Ameen to the Dua. Siti Bilal saying Ameen to the Dua. And Siti Bilal, many of the members of the IC family wishing you happy birthday. You can check in the chat, inshallah. Just Bibi Farid Babs and Umar from Pembroke Pines saying Ameen to the Dua. Sister Sarah Jarada from Richmond Hill saying Ameen to the Dua. Sister Bibi Rasul from Etobicoke saying Ameen to the Dua. Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah. Excellent. So we thank all of you for watching the program today. And once again, we hope you can be with us every day, 7 p.m. Toronto time. Please reach out to your family members, your relatives, your friends, and other Muslims you know. Tell them about the program. Encourage them to watch your program and sign into the chat. Inshallah, they'll benefit from the program. You'll receive increased blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So thanks to all of you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep you always in the shade of His special mercies. Until we meet again. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu.